Well, last week I was underneath my 2008 Jeep Wrangler, and I noticed that what I was doing, I was replacing the shifter cable, and I noticed that my front DriveShaft boot here at the transfer case is torn, and it's slinging grease everywhere, so I'm going to go ahead and replace that today. What I did is, Chrysler doesn't offer a boot kit or anything for the DriveShaft. They want you to buy a whole DriveShaft, which we're not going to do that. So I went on eBay, I was looking around, and they sell some rebuilt kits for the CV shaft, CV part of it up there. And they also sell, I found that they sell just the boot. So I went ahead and just got the boot. It was a lot cheaper just to get the boot. Don't really have any noise or anything coming out of the DriveShaft. So I figured I'll just replace the boot, because pretty much all it is this rubber. Rubber's torn and it's slinging the grease out, so go ahead and pull the drive shaft and replace that. Alright. First things first, just to make this a little easier, I think I'm going to remove this shield so I can get the drive shaft out a little easier. I think I can do it without taking it off, but I'm going to take it off just to make it a little bit easier. You're gonna need to replace, you need to remove these bolts right here. I think they're all 18 millimeter, just zip them out. Pull the shield down. Here, I went ahead and marked the drive shaft just in case, you know, later on if I do U-joints or whatever, it's good just to mark where it's at. You want to keep it in balance. Bad boys are on there pretty tight. It feels good still. These bad boys are gonna be eights. And you're gonna need a socket. I hate fucking working on my back. I'm gonna mark where we have this. I guess it's a big washer. mark where this one's at. I want to put it back exactly. Just due to balancing issues, I don't want to take this thing apart again. So. Snap ring. Right there.
I want this one.
What I did is I went to some bigger tips. These tips are too small. I felt like I was going to break them off. They break real easy, so.
Part. See a lot of grease in it. Cool.
You can buy the kit where it comes with the whole new bearings and everything like that, but I went the cheap route. I just wanted the rubber part. Boop.
some of the old grease out. Catches pretty quick. You see where it gets hot. It's really hot. It's crazy. Alright. I don't want to get these mixed up. Pretty sure this is the outside.
Thank you.
Oh, I forgot. Forgot the new gasket. So, there we go. These things have a gasket.
The mark I made, the remember where I put these at, was on the top, so I started with that one.
Try to get them where they kind of need to go. Cause I don't want to mess with balancing issues and shit and weird vibrations and shit.
Tough. And go ahead and put your shield back on. And when you're done, you find out the torque specs on those and go back and torque those down later. But once you do the boot, and back drive shaft the same way. So just take a look at those. Might have to do those one day. The angle's a little crazy on that one. I think that's one goes off first. Yeah. I do the boot on the drive shaft on the new Jeep Wranglers. Not too bad. There's the kit I used. I love eBay. Not bad. Cheap.